According to the recent report by the Parliamentary Committee of National Economy, the delayed implementation of the Kampala Jinja Expressway has attracted a hemorrhage of 4.1 billion shillings in commission fees.
I was informed that the delay in the implementation is partly attributed to Cabinet and Parliament's approval conditions that delayed the project by 18 months, as well as delayed procurement of the project implementation unit due to lack of readily available skills in the region.
The total cost of the project is $1,482.28 million, approximately 5.4 trillion shillings. Apart from the 1.2 trillion shillings coming from the African Development Bank and French Development Agency, the Uganda government will contribute $301 million, about 1.1 trillion, and receive a grant of €90 million, approximately 389.1 billion shillings. The Kampala Jinja Expressway started in 2015, but it has remained at procurement stage 8 years later, which is partly blamed on Cabinet and Parliament's loan approval conditions.
Government of Uganda projects unilaterally should ensure that timely implementation to create the much needed fiscal space that shall be required in 2 years' time. Now that this one has to be cleared within 2 years after implementation.
Legislators have come out to pile pressure on government to take stock of previous projects and kick off the implementation of the project before the taxpayers incur more losses that may accrue in terms of interest.
There is fundamentally a big problem with the way we acquire loans in this country. Many times when the government comes for loans, they are not ready. You find sometimes studies, including feasibility studies, which should have been part of this kind of acquisition process, are not done. And as a result, some delays are unwarranted.
Whether the loan is not utilized at that moment, for them, they may earn even a commission. And this is what we are seeing, and this is what we suspect, possibly. Because prudence demands that you should acquire credit when you are ready to utilize it. When you are not ready to utilize it, you cannot borrow money.
MPs have faulted the government for shooting first and aiming later by procuring loans without absorption plans.
Particularly happened on the Jinja Express Highway that we borrowed money to undertake a project, whereas we were not ready as a country. We had not done enough feasibility study on the road, on the route, including compensation of the PAPs.
The loans are underperforming, and it should have been the Committee on National Economy to ensure these matters are addressed.
Lawmakers have a mixed view on the need for the government to establish an independent authority in charge of loan management. They believe this can improve efficiency in loan absorption and implementation of related projects.
Who are borrowing are the ones in charge of the resource mobilization. So they must be together.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.